Hey everyone! Welcome to our very special bedtime Christmas story time from the Scott County Public Library in Georgetown, Kentucky. We've got our jammies on, we've got our stuffies, we've got our songs and our bells. And we're so excited for you to join us for this very special story time. So if you've got bells at home and a stuffie, you can go grab it now. We are so excited to share this holiday story time stories with you.
So we're going to start off with just a little poem finger play thing. And I'm going to start it. We're going to do it twice, right? And I'm going to say the line, and then you can say the line after me.
There you go.
That's what we're going to do. And we'll do it twice, okay? See the snowflakes falling.
See the snowflakes falling.
See the candles glow.
See the candles glow.
See the wreaths upon the doors.
See the wreaths upon the doors.
It's Christmas time, we know.
It's Christmas time, we know.
I like that one a lot. Let's do it again, okay? Ready? See the snowflakes falling.
See the snowflakes falling.
See the candles glow.
See the candles glow.
See the wreaths upon the doors.
See the wreaths upon the door.
It's Christmas time, we know.
It's Christmas time, we know.
Yay, Christmas time.
Yay.
So Ms. Laura.
All right.
Story to us.
I'm going to read extra special book. This is called Bear Stays Up for Christmas. And this is written by Karma Wilson with illustrations by Jane Chapman. And we're reading this with permission from Simon & Schuster. Bear Stays Up for Christmas.
I love the story this
morning. The day before Christmas, snuggled on his floor, Bear sleeps soundly with a great big snore. Dear Bear, get up! Mouse shouts in his ear. We won't let you sleep through Christmas this year. His friends are all there, gathered in his lair, and the bear wakes. See all of his friends around him. He stands with a stretch, and a great big sigh. I hope I can make it. I do want to try. Don't worry, squeaks Mouse. Bear says, it's all right. We'll keep you busy all day and all night. All of his friends are gonna help him stay up for Christmas. He tries to lie down, but his friends all frown. So the bear stays up. It's hard for bears to stay up in the wintertime. Come on, says Badger, time to follow me. In Pine Grove Glen, there's a fine Christmas tree. So they stomp through the woods, and they tromp down the track. They hoist up the tree onto Bear's big back. Bear's probably the only one big enough to carry that big tree. Everybody's helping. He plods very slow as they trudge through the snow, but the bear stays up. Back at the cave, Gopher brews mint tea, and Mole pops corn to string upon the tree. Good. Raven and Wren bake a fresh fruit cake. The friends do their best to keep Bear awake. His shoulders start to stoop and his eyelids droop. But the bear stays up. He starts to fall over, but he saves it, saves the Christmas tree. They hang up their stockings by warm firelight and hum Christmas songs like, Oh, Holy Night. They cuddle and sing as they wait for the sun. dark, sleepy time. But soon all the voices fade to just one. A bright star glows while his good friends doze. But the bear stays up. Bear giggles and grins. He works and he raps. He bustles and bakes while everyone naps. He piles up presents under the tree. But who's at the doorway? Bear doesn't see. You guys see who's at the doorway? He toils all night until the sun rises, making his friends their Christmas surprises. Just before dawn, he lets out a yawn. But he still stays up. When Christmas arrives so lovely and white, Bear's friends awake to a glorious sight. Presents and goodies all piled up tall. I stayed up, says Bear, just to share with you all. Look at the beautiful tree, all the presents. As his friends shout with glee, Bear lies by the tree, but he still stays up. The badger has a sled, a jump rope with a mouse, all sorts of fun things. Wren flies to the stockings and tweets out a cheer. Besides our bear's presents, Santa was here. When all gifts are opened, there's one last surprise. Badger shows Bear a quilt, just his size. So everybody got presents, even Bear. Bear snuggles up tight and mutters, good night. Then Bear falls asleep. All of his friends are there with him. His friends tidy up and slip from the lair. They whisper, sweet dreams. Merry Christmas, dear Bear. The end.
Yay. I think it's time to dance.
I think so.
That's what makes me so sleepy, but I think we should dance. We're going to do Jingle Bells. This is Laurie Berkner's version of Jingle Bells, and we're doing this with permission of Laurie Berkner. Are your bells ready?
I like those J-I-N-G-L bells, those J-I-N-G-L bells, those
what fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh.
song is very jingly.
Yes. Very jingly. Yeah.
We're going to jingle some more.
We're going to jingle.
We're going to
jingle. We're going to do this twice so that you can join in with us a second time.
Yes.
Five little bells all in a row. The first one said, ring me slow.
The fourth one said, ring.
She's had too much macaroni and cheese today. Let's do that again.
The first one.
We're going to start all over again. Five little bells all in a row. And the first one said, ring me slow.
The second one said, ring me fast.
And the third one said, ring me last.
The fourth one said, I'm like a chime.
Bong, bong, bong.
And they all said, ring, it's Christmas time.
Yay! Right, we're going to do that one more time.
Okay.
Five little bells all in a row. The first one said, ring me slow.
The second one said, ring me fast.
Third one said, ring me last.
And the fourth one said, I'm like a chime.
Bong, bong, bong.
And they all said, ring me at Christmas time.
Woo! All right. All right.
Hold on to your bells. We're going to do one more later.
With the bells. Oh, yes. Hold on.
You're going to read your book next.
Yes.
Next, we're going to read Ten for Christmas by Catherine Falwell, illustrated by Catherine Falwell, and with permission of Clarion Books. So here we go. One star for the top of the Christmas tree. Did you have a star for the top of your Christmas tree? Two angels with wings. See their little ornaments? Three royal kings. Look at them. How colorful. Four children play in harmony. Uh-oh, the musical sort here. Five snuggle up near, all doing story time like us. Six stories to hear. Seven tasty candy canes. Eight reindeer that fly. Look, it's on her paper, her Christmas wrapping paper. Nine ribbons to tie. Bet you have lots of ribbons to tie this year. Ten hands string the popcorn chain. Look it, everybody gets to play. And we're back to one. One wreath welcomes guests to the door. Two will make, and three will bake. Four will taste and ask for more. Five baskets to pack. Wonder if they're gonna give those away. Six presents to stack. That's always fun, present Jenga. Seven bright candles standing tall. Nice. Eight voices to sing. Do you like to sing? I hope so. Hope you're helping us. Nine silver bells ring. Keep those bells handy. And we're back to 10. 10 joyful folks wish peace for all.
as do we to you.
The end.
Yay.
All right, we're going to sing up the name with our bells.
Yes.
So get your bells out again.
Very good.
And this song is out to the tune of Jimmy Crack Corn. If you don't know that song, you know that song. It goes like this. Ring those bells and turn around. Ring those bells and turn around. Ring those bells and turn around. Christmas time is here. Ring those bells and stomp your feet. Ring those bells and stomp your feet. Ring those bells and stomp your feet. Christmas time is here.
Yes, I take my slippers off for this one.
Ring those bells and jump up and down. Ring those bells and jump up and down. Ring those bells and jump up and down. Christmas time is here.
Awesome.
All right.
So much fun.
Yes. All right. What is next?
Mistletoe.
Oh, it's mistletoe. Yeah.
It's time for mistletoe.
All right.
I've never heard this story much.
This is a really cute one. And it's a newish book. It's just a couple months old that we've had. And it's called Mistletoe. And it's a Christmas story written and illustrated by Tad Hills. And, oh, I lost my giraffe head. Hold on. I'm going to put my giraffe back. Okay. And read with permission from Schwartzwaig Random House Books. All right, ready? Mistletoe! And there's little Mistletoe. She's a mouse. Mistletoe greets the chilly morning. Snow is falling. What a beautiful day! Finally, it feels like Christmas, she thinks. By the time she gets to Norwell's house, the snow is almost up to her knees. Norwell, come out! It's snowing! Mistletoe calls. Norwell watches Mistletoe. It sure looks cold out there, Norwell says to himself. Too cold for this elephant. Mistletoe, it's cold out there. Why don't you come in, sit by the fire, and have some tea? He yells out the door. Just a drop for me and a cookie crumb, please, says Mistletoe. And after tea, we can go for a walk in the snow. Norwell and Mistletoe sit by the warm and toasty fire. Isn't this nice, Mistletoe? Asks Norwell. Oh, yes, indeed it is, Mistletoe agrees. But wouldn't it be also nice to take a stroll in the snow? Later, Mistletoe helps Norwell decorate his tree. After we top it off with a star, can we go out and catch snowflakes on our tongues? Says Mistletoe. I don't know. Norwell walks to the window. He watches the snowfall. Brrr, he says. It looks even colder out there now. Mistletoe, I think I'll stay home where it's cozy. So Mistletoe puts on her hat, coat, scarf, and mittens, and sets out on her walk home. She soon finds herself in a field of snow. As evening approaches, the world turns blue. She stops. She is as quiet and still as she has ever. Norwell should be here with me to listen to the falling snow, she thinks. Suddenly, she has an idea. Mistletoe cannot get home fast enough. When she gets inside, she tosses off her snow-covered clothes. She climbs into her attic and finds just what she needs. Do you see what she finds? These are boxes, and they say yarn, 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 and yarn. So I think she found yarn. She gathers her yarn, settles in with her knitting needles, and gets to work. You can never have too much yarn, she says to herself. There she is. Mistletoe knits whenever she can. She knits when the sun comes up and when the sun is down. She knits while she reads. She knits while she makes cookies for Santa. She even knits in the bath, which isn't easy. Days pass. Christmas nears. Mistletoe knits and knits, using every bit of yarn she can find around her house. Mistletoe realizes two things. One, sometimes you don't have enough yarn. And two, elephants are big. She stops at her favorite shop and brings home as much yarn as she can. And that would be yarn, 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 and yarn. Finally, on Christmas Eve, Mistletoe puts down her knitting needles. Her fingers are tired. Her work is done. She watches the snow fall outside her window and thinks of Norwell. Oh, Christmas. And she smiles. Then Mistletoe nestles into her soft knitting and falls into a deep sleep. Look at all the knitting. It's everywhere. The next morning, Mistletoe opens her eyes as the sun fills her living room. Christmas is here! The cookies are gone and beautifully wrapped gifts have been left under the tree. Thank you, Santa! She calls up the chimney, Merry Christmas! Opening her presents will have to wait, though, because Mistletoe has other plans. First, she puts on her Christmas dress. Then she carefully folds the gift that she has made for Norwell and adds a red ribbon. There it is. And that's her doorway, and it doesn't fit. And she squeezes the gift through the front door. Just barely, she's using her feet, she's pushing it. Oh my goodness, it doesn't fit. And she pulls the heavy gift behind her on a sled. Merry Christmas, Norwell! I have something for you, she calls when she reaches her friend's house. Merry Christmas, Mistletoe, Norwell says. Come in, come in. I have something special for you, too. Norwell hands Mistletoe the most beautifully wrapped package she's ever seen. Mistletoe carefully opens it and discovers a painting of her in the snow. He made her his own little portrait of her. It's perfect, Norwell. You do love snow, Mistletoe. Indeed I do. When it's Norwell's turn to open his gifts, Mistletoe asks, do you know what it is, Norwell?
I don't know what it is, but I love it.
Oh, Mistletoe, it's so colorful and soft, Norwell exclaims. It will keep you toasty and warm, Mistletoe tells Norwell. Outside in the snow. You do like to be toasty and warm, Norwell, said Mistletoe. Indeed, I do, agreed Norwell. And he was. Look what she made him! A giant striped elephant onesie! Yay. I just love that picture. The end.
Oh, I do like that book. Well, we're kind of winding our story time down here. We're going to do kind of a bedtime song, right? A Christmas Eve song. And then we're going to read one last book. Ready? Okay. Do some music. This is another Laurie Berkner song. And we have to get up and dance to this, don't we?
Yes.
Of course. Yes. There's some movement.
Yes, we do. We have to.
Do we need our bells for this one?
Can't go wrong with bells.
Yeah. Do we have a frozen music computer?
I think we have a frozen music computer.
We're going to reload it one more time. Make sure we can get it up there. And during this interlude, this is a reminder that we do have lots of great Christmas books that you can check out from the Scott County Library. Mm-hmm. And also Hanukkah and Kwanzaa and everything in between.
We sure do. Winter
solstice. You do ask to be nice to your neighbor. And don't take more than five.
Yes, we can all share some nice holiday books. Mm-hmm.
How's it looking, Miss Lauren?
It does not want to wake up.
No internet. Oh, boo-hoo.
Oh, here we go. Okay,
wait.
It's back.
Gotta have a good jingle song to do jingles.
This is a new one for us. We just discovered this when we were looking for some music for this program. It's a good song.
We're so thankful to Laurie Berkner and all her great music.
It's Christmas. It's time for sleep, but I'm awake instead. Mom and Dad have said goodnight, but I still want to hear the sound. Christmas Eve. I'm lying in my bed. It's time for sleep, but I'm awake instead. I left my favorite cookies and some leaves for Rudolph too. I hope you like my lemonade. I colored it bright blue. Because Santa's coming to my house tonight. And I keep waiting for you.
Up with, you have probably heard this story before, the night before Christmas. This is an old one. This is written a long time ago. It was written by Clement C. Moore. This particular version is illustrated by Lauren Long, who is from Lexington. He now lives in Cincinnati, but he's a fabulous illustrator. And I like this version. I picked it because it shows four different houses in four different parts of the world. So I thought that was kind of neat. The Night Before Christmas by Clement C. Moore. Pictures by Lauren Long, and we're reading this with permission of HarperCollins Publisher. I'm gonna have to have my glasses for this. I hope you'll check this out and look at the pictures. They're just great.
Yeah,
it's a really good illustrator. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even the stockings were hung by the chimney with care in the hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. If you look at this picture, you'll see this man doesn't have a chimney. Mm-hmm. He drew a picture mm-hmm. on a chimney so Santa could come down.
Yes.
That was very clever. The children were nestled all snug in their beds while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled in for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew in a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave the luster of midday to the objects below. When what to my wondering eye should appear but a miniature sleigh and eight tiny reindeer. With the little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a minute it must be Saint Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted, and he called them by name. Now, Dasher, now, Dancer, now, Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donder and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now, dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount up to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew, with the sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. I drew in my head and was turning around Down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his sack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, and his nose was like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was right chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, and then he turned with a jerk. And laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and they all flew away like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, ere he drove out of sight, "Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night." And that's the end. And we wish you all a very, very Merry Christmas and a happy, happy holiday.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you at the library.
Yeah, come see us. Come see us at the library. Get some books.